They feel they are being excluded because of their status, poverty, sero status, and perhaps because they are women.
Aboma ati gani siri kumbali ya chitandizo cha chakuja. Kutipa metu kumama mkwala wa. Tika maja soka chakuja wa metu. Wala ati kumari bata mapalaja. Ata umagula nchiro nto mwetu.
Those they look up to so that they can remain on their feet are turning their eyes and ears away.
Hii unabuwa chitandizo hili ya ntu wapo Stevie. Kumano vizi kuti angurenga auja auja auja. Ndebo hili ukakalaosa ugoma koro ulibe kolo wera. Ulibe mpavweru kuzoka fusori za karabanji.
Their traditional leaders urged them to come out in the open to declare their status and promise that their situations would be prioritized. For years, it has remained a promise and nothing else. Now they have been severely hit by hunger. In their condition, the food crisis can become deadly.
Dorinda Tasabara, Disa Uja Jawuja Yoenera, Monga Menin Madrida Zajawuja Zamarubiatu. De for your so Jawuja. Mabes the Godiman and Tawina Mankala Jendu Madumpa, Bolinga Rimanka Nima Banji, Jalan Mene Lidi.
Of course, there are some chiefs who show compassion and have sent distress signals to higher authorities.
Mankala, Mafula Jawuja.
As the sun sets in this village on the outskirts of Balaka town, most of those who are on treatment become anxious about what the night might bring. They may not take their medication on hungry stomachs. There's a portion of Balaka district that is always covered in green. It knows no season. Of course, charcoal production is threatening the vast expanse on the district's roadsides, but the attack is not severe yet. In other sections of the Eastern Region district with one of the lowest populations in Malawi, the picture is rather different. Droughts and dry spells often strike and leave households with little or nothing to harvest. On the outskirts of Balaka town center, a vast village Zamimba within the jurisdiction of sub-traditional authority Matola wakes up to a troubling day every day during months like these. Elsewhere, hunger is biting hard too, but those on treatment have to bear a bigger burden. They are already struggling to improve their health.
My end grandchildren and disease, Mabes got in Mina Jizunguide, Mina Tima Tamanga, so intended of me. De Kumbaya Jawuya, Oriba Noble, Garinda Bezaga Jawuya, Cordin and the Saga Yamanga, Cordimina, because I know very me, Saga Big Gamozi, Cordimina, and the Yoga Timasiguri.
This woman has found some solace in the company of others sharing her sorrow status. They often come together to share hope, frustrations, and the future. Oftentimes, they feel neglected by the traditional leaders who apparently divert the support from well wishes meant for those on treatment. Chimbalanga Feather states that even the aid that comes directly from the government often ends up in wrong hands. As the sun drops behind a range of hills lining up Balaka's western stretch, hope drops too for several women on treatment. They find it difficult to take their medication on empty stomachs. And HIV research experts warn the default and delay to start medication is contributing to the return of AIDS among some people.
Those other big diseases are coming back again. So we could say that because that time we would say that the patient has AIDS, more or less. That's an AIDS defining disease, but that's what we used to call. So what I could correlate now is that maybe now we should be thinking, we should be talking about that the AIDS is back because we are now seeing a lot more sick people.
Eston Kolimbo has been on treatment for 16 years and 7 years ago managed to deliver a bubbly baby boy free of the infection, but with a heart problem. Kolimbo cannot effectively work in her crop fields because already she's failing to access the required food nutrients ideal for her condition. Thus, she's struggling to bring food on her family's table. Her son's heart problem requires that she frequently travels to Queen Elizabeth Central Hospital for checkup. Once in a while, she catches the train, which is cheaper compared to passenger buses. She's not always lucky and often skips the scheduled appointments for her son. As she battles her own challenges, Kolimbo wishes her son would live a comfortable life. These women, with some having been taking their medication for close to 2 decades, know very well the implications of hunger on their conditions. Even medical experts state that those on treatment must have access to nutritious foods to supplement the impact of the life-prolonging drugs. And these women know all the necessary food groups which would help in improving their health, but they still lack them.
Timasawa zambiri, mezi makuza, zaguja, chifoja uti ifeti mama mwankwala, ofuna kutiti konzo kumaja zaka sinta, kutiti kale ndi moyo wa tanzi.
Manyowa and several other affected women are often excluded and feel stigmatized by their own leaders. They are the same leaders who urge these women to come out in the open so that they can be prioritized in case of any support flowing down into this hunger-stricken location. Now the declaration of their status appears to be hurting them harder, so they feel.
I first somebody tengera mbali anthu okudzidwa. Ndi ifeti mamva zisoni timalira mu mtima mwathu. Timatenga chigawo chimene kuti akutisankhula monga anthu oti ifeti kumwa mankhwala.
But in a way, coming out in the open about their status is also helping them build their confidence and speak with one voice.
They have now realized that it's good to come out and declare yourself that you are HIV positive. At first, it was very difficult because stigma and discrimination was at high. So people were not able to disclose their status.
Kolimbo takes her medication every evening before retiring to bed. A note on her phone faithfully reminds her about the treatment that is prolonging her life. But it is not every time the reminder beeps and flashes on her phone that she positively responds to it. Without proper food in her house, she often skips the medication. She has previously battled terrible disorders after taking the drugs on empty stomachs, she says.
Iwe muna tikisema tira jangu angolowa mukamutwa nthai mine ili nthai noye nthai anjala ukangolosa jajina chiri jose ndokanika mankhala umu ndasanga gure bwino chito amanda wakati uli ndi chakudya utanga mankhala japiti tsako jaumwa ndima mama dzira kokho bogono ukwandanga madzira jaumwa bogono mama madza dzoma dzoka ndi chani ndi mphavu ndi kugira bwino chito koma pesa ngati chakudya ngati sina jamadzu palibe jina yisimbe chingachitike foma khathu lako lofoka.
Hunger appears to dominate the problems that people on treatment in this location face. For 52-year-old Gladys Mandanda, stigma was once the biggest threat to her health. Her memory of how the drugs she would take about a decade ago turned out to be less effective because of stress are still fresh. Today, a problem common in this Eastern Region district has not spared her.
Name and kwandi number 206. Kufikana tayari rosozori babita ma minutes ambiri apa. Ndipo zotero zindume mafuna zoti zimankaroza pa nthemene uchipatala ako situkukwanitsa kamba ndimene ziliri ndimene opanda business ndimene iliyonse uchita.
Now opportunistic infections that were frequently kept at bay are lurking around her. It has been one of the greatest fears for this woman since she was initiated on treatment over a decade ago.
Ankwalaja ugamba mamwando ndomiki mama tuzira ndiwe munthu onori malungo singawiri kawiri kudwala ndipo soma bwerera so nkati meonali thuka kuloyamba inde zimatheka kubwera nori wewe ufuna kudwala komongo nthenga ngono zabalalika osadwalaso nde mwina ngumatha chaka osadwala ulomuthu.
And doctors warn that interrupting treatment can be deadly, even when one feels they are fine. For the rest of their lives, they are supposed to adhere to all guidelines for their own health.
The interruption of treatment actually makes your body to be susceptible for these other diseases. A lot of people used to come up with several other diseases, maybe TB, meningitis, or various forms caused by various parasites and bacteria.
Streams which could supply water for irrigation during the dry season vanish with the end of the rainy season in Zamimba village. For even those willing to venture into winter cropping, their dreams remain just like that. A narrow earth road that connects this village and Balaka town center has vast maize fields on its sides. But these crops are also at the mercy of droughts and prolonged dry spells so prevalent in this part of Malawi. So these bold and hard-working women are also at the mercy of nature in their poverty and without any sustainable source of income.
They're facing a lot of challenges, especially those living in the villages. The first thing is their food shortages in their households is the one we have discovered, and lack of money to sustain their needs. Others got malnutrition, but because they don't have money to buy what they want, according to their status.
They are fighting hard to improve their lives, especially in terms of nutrition. Nevertheless, the hunger crisis that has gripped this village is threatening such efforts.
So, what did you say? I'm going to go to the business. I'm going to go to the business. I'm going to go to the business. I'm going to go to the drama. I'm going to go to the bank. I'm going to go to the bank.
In general, some people on treatment are able to access some food. The challenge, however, is that the food falls short of meeting the minimum nutrition standards for any human being. With messages about desired food groups for the health of everyone abundant in the country, these women on treatment know their deficits. And they know the trouble they are in.
Moneti matha kudzuka mama kumudzingati kuno tikungotenga mankhwala kumwa wopanda ulo china chili chonse kungomwa madzi ukatero kutenga khasi kupita kunyumba kupita kumunda kumakagwira ntchito yakuti yakumunda ndoti pobwera mwe kudya mpaka na 12 koloko kumimba kulibe chinene chine chichonse ndeti mangolimira ifo chaona kuti nangati panga bwanji poti tupanga zinthu zoti tidzithandize.
During all the 14 years since she was diagnosed HIV positive, Kalongoda has made every effort to manage her life in ways that she does not hurt others she might become intimate with, she says. She has faithfully kept that promise and is proud of her decision. Campaigners for the elimination of stigma and discrimination also believe that declaring one's status is crucial in fighting the spread of the epidemic. Kalongoda says when everything is in place, her antiretroviral drugs regimen works properly. It has improved her health apart from minimizing side effects such as dizziness and other disorders. So Kalongoda is among lucky people in treatment whose bodies are responding positively to their drugs. Others have tried different drugs regimens, but the results have not shown much improvement. Medical experts warn that problems that emanate from failure to align with various ARV regimes have the possibility of hastening advanced AIDS.
With such worse conditions, they also require specialized care and also various other drugs, plus other medical supplies like laboratory follow-up that come into play that may be before we are not actually foreseen in the, we have not foreseen in the care of HIV patients.
On the sides of the road that leads into Zamimba village, children are often placed by their parents and guardians to sell whatever can earn them some money. They are far away from classrooms and seem to have accepted that here is where their destiny lies. But these women on treatment refuse to go down with the prevalent tide. They regularly come together to share their pain, their pride, and their hope. It matters. Among them, unity is also flourishing, and they are always eager to hold each other's hand in moments of distress. This mother of three has experienced the compassion from others who share her status. They have always been by her side. She has seen others too being raised from their wretchedness. One of the biggest threats to controlling HIV is stigma and discrimination. They have so often driven those diagnosed with the virus into solitary confinement. But the coming together of these women is for a common purpose: to forge ahead with dynamism and reduce stress and depression, which could threaten their health. Still, the 56-year-old mother hopes a time will come when her life will be moderately back to normal. As a single mother, looking after her three children is not an easy task. There are activities that, in her condition, she says she cannot do to improve her income.
Enafendi mabachala awula awulu munga minezi wolili mbali ogira nchiro moyine lera dilibe mpavu yori likoza kugira business yokazigiga mpamba kutisowa ori ganka kumbu yori munakoza kutitandizira kumbali ori o mpambo yambira geni nduu kumbali achibale dilibe ori tandiza.
Village head Machingo concedes that in this part of Malawi, those on treatment face numerous problems which jeopardize their efforts to remain strong. On the other hand, he insists there is a significant reduction in stigma and discrimination.
Kalongoda maso kutalikira kwa zipatala zimene zimatengedwa mankhwala ama HIV tikilinga mafuta amene akulira ndithu.
The traditional leader shares thoughts of those who advocate for declaring one's sero status. He believes such acts can help in fighting the epidemic.
Kubisa kuti iwe anthu asakudziwe kumapangisa kuti iwe ukhale ndinde ofalitsa matendawo koma wakati ndithu iweyo munthu unali mapoyera anthu amadziwa kuti anzanga wandivulala kuti komanso iweyo munthu zimakuthandiza kuti udakhala wadwa madzidzidzi achibala savuli kuthandizayo.
And he led by example. He got tested for HIV and has been mobilizing his subjects to do the same. They can continue living healthy lives and contribute to national development, he says.
Ndiye kwa ine ndi njira imodzi imene imakhangala chipitika chitsanzo kwa anthu amudzi wanga kuti kukayezesa ndikufundikira foma dziwa mthupa umuliri komanso kuyamba mankhwala wa ndondomeko zimathandiza kuti thupa kukhala thanzi.
Manyowa recalls that just slightly over a decade ago, stigma was so high in our village that it was practically impossible to declare one's positive sero status. Those who tested positive rather chose to keep everything to themselves, including medication prescriptions.
Matika kalabantengo, amatiroza. Kutita awona nita kalabantengo vo, ama mama nkwala, ndia akachirombo. Koma ifesi di madanka hawai, di madziwa kumene rigurani, tikupita ndipo pano badidaka pangabe kuti talimbikitsa nzathu amene sana izetse.
She still pushes on and ensures a family of three does not instantly give up on her life. Together, they put up a fervent fight and it is paying dividends. Many of those who test positive are said to have problems accepting their status at first. They even fail to consistently take their drugs, a thing that affects their health and results into resistance.
Dida tupa nkhope miendo thupilo se lukhala ndithu munthu zani osinthika zinapezono zoti momwe nthemene kulinda munanga tisatsimphana kena kake anangoti amunanga aja kubwerera kubwera sozamba kukhala limozi pa nyumba pathu kumapanga chisamaliro chokwanira ndithu chokhuzana munthu amamuna mazi anthu awiri chakudya sechimata sechimavula zinapezori namba kuzilolera.
Faithfully taking medication saves unborn babies, experts state. It also suppresses the virus so that it cannot be transmitted to one's partner. Mwaziva's three children were born HIV negative because she followed doctor's advice on how she can protect others. She's also using art in the form of poetry and drama to fight off forms of discrimination directed at those diagnosed with the virus. She also attracts more people to get tested and come in the open about their status as a way of fighting discrimination.
Uthenga wanga ndiwothetsa kusalana maka kumbali ya mafumu amabungwe amipingo fama amipingo osuka amabungwe amathaso matisala.
She and several other women could be winning part of the battle. They have fought and continue fighting discrimination. They have reached out to several others to go for testing. They encourage each other not to default on treatment, but they are hungry.